In this tutorial video clip, we'll present how to create a freeform shading device for a multi-story building. We'll be using Rhinoceros and Grasshopper, developed by Robert McNeil and Associates, and ArchiCAD, developed by Graphisoft. The new connection between Rhinoceros, Grasshopper, and ArchiCAD offers seamless bidirectional geometry transfer between these applications. This also means that the basic geometrical shapes created in Rhinoceros can now be translated into full-fledged BIM elements in ArchiCAD while adding algorithmic editing functionality thanks to Grasshopper. After installing Rhinoceros with the Grasshopper add-on and ArchiCAD on your computer, please make sure that the Grasshopper ArchiCAD Live Connection tool is also installed and running. Let's begin the design using Rhino by creating two curved splines. We'll use the top view in Rhino and add the curved splines as presented in the video. Let's continue using Grasshopper by placing two curve parameters. The next step is to reference the Rhino curves with the help of the curve parameters. Please check out the Rhino and Grasshopper training materials for further details. This tutorial video focuses on presenting the new connection between these applications. Let's proceed and elevate one of the curved splines we created earlier using the Move component of Grasshopper. To define the direction of the motion, we connect a unit Z component to the Move component. To keep the height of the shading device flexible throughout the design process, we control the length of the vector with the number slider. We may also enter a name for this slider and define its minimum and maximum numeric values. Let's switch to the perspective view of Rhinoceros to see the number slider in action. If we modify the value stored by the slider, the position of the elevated curve in Rhino will change accordingly. Let's also create an equal number of division points on each of the curves in Grasshopper. We will use the Divide Curve component to achieve this. Let's add another instance to the other curve as well. Let's also add a number slider to be able to define the number of division points graphically. We can enter a name for the division slider in order to remember its function later on. By default, the number sliders store real numbers. In this case, however, we want to provide whole numbers with it. Let's connect this slider to both curves because we want to insert equal amount of division points. Please note that the newly added division points on the curved splines are also indicated in Rhinoceros. Now let's see how to transfer our design to ArchiCAD. Let's start the Grasshopper Connection plugin in ArchiCAD by using the Design, Design Extras, Grasshopper Connection command, and then clicking the Start Connection button. First, we'll define the desired ArchiCAD element in Grasshopper. Let's display the ArchiCAD tab page in Grasshopper. Please note that this tab contains various panels and numerous components. In this case, we'll select ArchiCAD's column element. The division points created earlier must also be transferred to the ArchiCAD column components. To make this happen, we must input the division points in Grasshopper as presented on the screen. Once all the previous steps are completed, the 3D view of ArchiCAD will automatically display the columns based on the geometry and distribution rule defined earlier in Rhino and Grasshopper. The created elements are native ArchiCAD column elements. These full-fledged BIM elements can be individually selected and edited if necessary. The Column Settings dialog may be opened to display and access all settings. Please note there was no need to send or receive any files to make this happen. Each ArchiCAD element type has a settings node in Grasshopper, so let's display the Column Settings node now. Each input parameter on the left of the Settings node corresponds to a parameter in the ArchiCAD Tool Settings dialog box. The right side of the Settings node has a single output parameter, which transfers the input data to the Design or Document component. Let's display the context menu of the Column Settings node by right-clicking it and modify the structure of the ArchiCAD columns. Let's select Circular Column from the list. The changes are instantly visible in ArchiCAD. All the generated columns are circular now. Let's adjust the Number of Division Points slider to modify the number of division points on the splines that defines the number of generated columns. Now let's add another number slider to the project. Next, we'll enter the name diameter and enter the required minimum diameter for the columns. Let's connect this to the input of the Settings node core diameter. We may use the new slider to modify the diameter of the generated columns in a single step. So now we have circular columns with dimensions controlled by our Grasshopper slider. Let's continue the design and create the horizontal elements that connect the columns of the shader. We'll use an ArchiCAD beam component triggered by the two splines. The ArchiCAD beam will ultimately be made up of small straight pieces because that's the way ArchiCAD handles splines. Please notice that the ArchiCAD 3D view is instantly and automatically updated. Now we have beam frames at the bottom and also at the top of the column structure created earlier. Let's see how quick and simple it is to refine the geometry of the frame structure in Grasshopper. Let's provide the beam components with a Settings node in Grasshopper. This will allow us to control the dimensions of the cross-sections of the beams. Let's also add a number slider as we did earlier. Let's call this Dimension. Let's connect this to the input side of the previously created beam component. We'll use this slider to control both the width and height dimensions of the generated columns. Lastly, we'll connect the Settings component to both the top and bottom beams in Grasshopper. Let's have a closer look at the ArchiCAD project. Here's the freeform shading device structure, created by columns and beams in 3D. We'll continue and see how to change certain ArchiCAD element attributes in Grasshopper. In the following example, we'll change the surface finish of the beams. The next step is to attach the building material input node to the beam component in Grasshopper. Let's select the timber structural material from the list. Finally, let's connect the building material input node to the Settings component. Please note that the results are instantly visible in the 3D window of ArchiCAd. Input nodes are special interface elements that retain certain data from the ArchiCAd project, making this data available to Grasshopper. The reference data are continuously updated. Input nodes can be attached to Settings nodes to control attributes, such as building material, composite, pen, etc., or the destination layer of the generated elements. In certain cases, we may prefer to use ArchiCAD's advanced editing tools to do custom changes on elements previously generated by Grasshopper. For instance, we can use ArchiCAD Surface Painter to change the surface finish of the selected columns in the 3D view. To do this, select the column component in Grasshopper. As a result, all corresponding elements will be selected in ArchiCAD as well. Please note that the elements are locked by default. All Grasshopper-generated elements are locked in ArchiCAD by default to prevent accidental editing. To enable editing, we need to first unlock them by selecting the Unlock command in the Edit menu. Now we may continue and use Surface Painter to select different colors and surface properties for individual ArchiCAD elements previously generated by the Grasshopper algorithm. Here's the freeform shading device having columns with different surface finishes, thanks to ArchiCAD's Surface Painter. The good news is that these ArchiCAD elements are still connected to the Grasshopper code. Let's use the number of division points slider to prove this. If we increase the number of division points on the splines, the number of columns also increases. This is immediately visible in the ArchiCAD 3D view. Please note that the colored columns are still visible in ArchiCAD. Our custom changes to the individual columns stayed in effect even after the Grasshopper code was recomputed. Now let's adjust the geometry of the original splines in Rhino by repositioning some of the nodes of the freeform splines. Notice that the ArchiCAD view is instantly updated. Please remember that thanks to the new live connection between Rhinoceros, Grasshopper, and ArchiCAD, designers may use a truly unique parametric freeform design in a professional building information modeling environment.